Today, the AHEPA is honoring one of their own. He's past president, Andrew Zachariades. Andrew, the room is filled. The show is not yours, but these people are all here for you. How are you feeling about seeing these folks today?
It really is quite an honor, because as much as they're here to recognize me as a past Supreme President, it really is recognizing the AHEPA and the AHEPA family for almost 100 years of service and legacy to the Greek community. I was proud to serve as Supreme President, but really it's about everybody here. It's about what we do for our community. It's how we give back. It's all the contributions to cancer research, to feeding the poor, for the service dogs, for the wounded warriors, homeless people. That's what we're about.
The organization you've been with for many years, what have you learned and seen through this organization? How has it influenced you?
I think the biggest thing that that has affected me is that no matter where you travel, whether it's Canada, Greece, Brussels, Germany, you name the country, the impact that we have as an AHEPA family, I was really taken back that when we, and the service that we give back to everybody, as well as when we speak on Hellenic issues, whether it's at the EU, whether it's at the State Department, what we say as an organization has a significant influence for everybody.
And a final thought today, where are we going? What's the future for AHEPA?
The future of AHEPA, without question, is we respect our legacy, how we got here today, but the future also is understanding and recognizing that we as a community are changing, and we have to embrace the young people today, understand the methodology of speaking has changed tremendously. Doesn't mean we change our core value. It's really understanding how we can now communicate in a different medium, embracing it, and teaching the young people why AHEPA matters, and to embrace that and take it to the future.
What Andy has done for the Order of AHEPA, he's built upon the great leadership that came before him, and he put AHEPA on a clear path to where we're focusing more on the brand and focusing on significant issues. What AHEPA's strengths are, it's in our chapters, 400 chapters across the globe. We've got chapters that are spending hundreds of thousands of dollars promoting Hellenism. We have a chapter in St. Louis, Missouri that just endowed a Hellenic studies program at the University of Missouri. Part of this comes from what Andy has been talking about, promoting the AHEPA brand. Getting us to look at, this is where we are today. We're no longer here just to help people assimilate in society. We're here to help people network. We're here to remind people of the Hellenic ideals and values that make America great. Our country has taken more of these values and done more with them than any other country on the face of the earth or the history of the world. Through Andy's leadership, we have continuity. So you're going to see from the next few presidents, including myself and those that follow me, that we're going to be focusing on the brand and what's important to make sure that we are representing the ideals and values and that those are never lost. That's more important than anything else that we can do. And if you look at the side effects of what happens, you look at the amount of money that ends up being raised for cancer research, you look at the amount of money that's being raised for scholarships, you look at the amount of money that's being raised for shelters for battered women, you look at the vet program. We have a warrior dog program that's second to none in this country, that we're able to deal with current issues, not just historical issues, and mobilize our organization to be able to make a meaningful impact to change the lives of people in a positive way. And that's what Andy helped start. If it wasn't for Andy, I wouldn't be where I'm at, and I wouldn't have what little success I've had without him. Andy has taught all of us many important concepts that we need to use to develop and grow the Order of AHEPA.
Το να μιλήσει κανείς για τον Άνδριου σήμερα, πρέπει να, οτιδήποτε πρέπει να το εντάξει σε ένα γενικότερο πλαίσιο. Που το γενικότερο πλαίσιο είναι η προσφορά των AHEPA στον ανθρώπων αυτών που για τόσα πολλά χρόνια έχουν προσπαθήσει να υπερασπιστούν τα συμφέροντα της ομογένειας, ξεκινώντας από πολύ πολύ πίσω μέχρι σήμερα. Σήμερα νομίζω ότι ο ρόλος τους είναι περισσότερο επίκαιρος και πιο σημαντικός από ποτέ. Και σε αυτό θα γυρίσω να πω για τον Άνδριου, ότι ο Άνδριου υπήρξε ως ο ύπατος πρόεδρος και προσέφερε πάρα πολλά στην ελληνική ομογένεια. Πάρα πολλά για τους εθνικούς σκοπούς, κράτησε την οργάνωση ενωμένη, ενεργή και νομίζω ότι θα μας λείψει.
Τον Άντι Ζαχαριάδη τον γνώρισα στις Βρυξέλλες όταν ήμουν μόνιμος αντιπρόσωπος πριν ένα χρόνο και πραγματικά με εξέπληξε η καθαρότητα της σκέψης του αλλά και ο πατριωτισμός του. Έχει ένα ρομαντικό πατριωτισμό. Ταυτόχρονα, όπως γνωρίζουν όλοι, έχει επιτελέσει ένα και επιτελεί ένα μεγάλο έργο στο φιλανθρωπικό. Και όλα αυτά βεβαίως αφήνουν τις καλύτερες εντυπώσεις και μόνο φίλους κερδίζει. Έχει κάνει εξαιρετική δουλειά σαν Supreme President της AHEPA και είμαστε πολύ περήφανοι που έχουμε Έλληνες που συνεχίζουν να προωθούν αυτές τις αξίες που είναι παγκόσμιες αξίες εδώ στον αμερικανικό χώρο. Και δεν ξέρω αν το γνωρίζετε, αλλά ο Άντι είναι και κυπριακής καταγωγής.
Well, Andy Zachariades was a very outstanding individual, first and foremost. As you know, when you're in AHEPA, the individual is a large component of what we have. A family man, a wonderful person, but more importantly, in terms of his short tenure as a president, he reinvigorated the I guess calling of AHEPA, which is the value set of AHEPA itself, to promote individual excellence and family and talipa ke talipa. In addition, he also had a secondary aspect which probably will be looked upon by history, and that is reinvigoration of going out and spreading the gospel, if we will, of AHEPA, not only to districts and chapters, but through continents. And that's what made Andy such a unique president. And also with a little tinge of Jersey brashness with it. So it was a unique combination, but it worked for Andy. And it all went to the benefit of all of our members, whether it was the AHEPA, the daughters, as well as the junior orders. So I'm proud. I'm proud because he's from this neck of the woods, so to speak. And as you can see here, so many people came to honor past Supreme President, as well they should, as they do with others. But in this particular case, for me, you know, it gets me right here. So, you know, we're proud. We're proud of Andy. Andy, congratulations on a job well done. Banda Axios. And, you know, we're looking forward to a continued progression of the Order of AHEPA throughout the AHEPA domain.
Well, we're very happy and proud to be able to come together as an AHEPA family to pay tribute to a great president in Andrew Zaharaitis. You'll see around the room many past presidents and members of his lodge that worked together to make sure that the AHEPA was better the day after he finished than when he started.
And a little bit something about Andrew. Tell us about who he is.
Well, Andy is a very unique individual. Coming from New Jersey, and I'm from Philadelphia, we sort of talk the same language. But once he got out of the New Jersey area, it sort of looked like he was a part of the Sopranos television show. So I really like the way he delivered some of his speeches.
So Andrew has been one of the most foremost excellent presidents we've had in recent memory. He really committed himself to visiting chapters and growing the AHEPA brand. And he was exceptional when it came to the AHEPA protocols. He grew up in the AHEPA. He was very, very rigid about the AHEPA rituals and about the AHEPA protocols. And he just did a wonderful job endearing himself to the members. And I think that's the most important thing. When the members love you, they come out for you, they support you, and they do, they really put forth your plan. And that's what Andrew was really most successful about.
Well, Andy was my vice president, and when I was Supreme President, and so I've watched him carefully over 2 years. He's very supportive. He was of me, but more importantly, he was supportive of all AHEPA ideals. And I think he represents AHEPA very well. He's a man of commitment and work and delivering results.
Andy Zachariades' tenure as Supreme President of AHEPA was really one of the best years, and actually best 5 years, while he was on the Supreme Lodge. So much was accomplished, both for our culture and for our organization. that I think we are honored to be here to pay tribute to him, because he gave up so much of his life, so much of his well-being for our cause, that I think this is a very fitting tribute for him, and I think we'll be remembering him for a long time.
Okay, well, I served with Andrew. I was district governor of New York. George Koryatis was district governor of New Jersey, and Andy was our supreme governor. So we served together, now for the last 6-7 years. This is the beauty of AHEPA. You meet people, you get close to people, we're family friends now. He truly is one of the best guys you'll find around anywhere. He cares for the organization. Now he's on the board of trustees, so he continues to give back. He's been instrumental in Jersey. He's been instrumental in his chapter with his church. Great to happen. Great to happen. We're just honored to be here today with my wife to celebrate his term as Supreme President.